User interface design, or UI design, is a word that's thrown around a lot. And in this video, I'm going to go through what user interface design is and why it's probably more important than the features of your application, because people's perception of your application and what it looks like is almost more important than the features underneath it. I'm Matt Grace, Managing Director of Flying Donkey. Let's get into it. What is user interface design? User interface design is simply the design of a page on the screen. These can come down to text or color elements, layouts, styling and button designs, to form elements, navigation and more. UI elements is really how the page looks to an end user. And don't be confused too much with user experience, though these two things do cross over. User experience is more about how the application works and feels and how things link together. User interface design is really how it looks to the user. A couple of things to mention here around user interface design. It's things around how easy is the site to navigate? Is it easy for a user to understand what's going on? Is the design outdated? And how easy are the pages to read? I'll go into these in a bit more detail later in the video. But again, overall, user interface design is the look and feel of the website. What does a UI designer do? A UI designer is the person in charge of actually making the user interface design. They're going to pull together these buttons, these colors, fonts, layouts, etc. in various different applications. Here at Flying Donkey, our designers generally use Figma, though sometimes they use other applications such as InVision, Photoshop, and Sketch. A UI designer is really around making the interface look and match the brand, making sure it's clear and communicates what it needs to the user, and trying to give the overall website a good look so users understand what's going on. Depending on the size of the company, you can sometimes split the UI and UX designer into two, but generally speaking, they're going to form into one person. Here at Flying Donkey, our designers are both UI and UX, because generally we find that when you're designing an application, particularly a SaaS product, the interface itself and how its user experience works is intertwined. And they will integrate both of these things into a single prototype, and I'll speak about prototypes in another video. What are the components of UI design? First one, navigation elements. Navigation elements are going to be the things you see and interact with to navigate around a particular website. They're going to be the nav bar at the top, the nav bar down the side, the footer at the bottom, etc. It's key to also understand that you need to think about how these user interfaces work on different screen sizes. So for example, a menu on a mobile application is going to be what they call the hamburger style menu. That's where you have three simple lines stacked on top of each other to give the user the ability to drop down the menu and navigate around. Second piece they're going to put together is informational components. These are going to be generally videos, text, and pictures. This is going to make up the bulk of your website and bulk of the content you're trying to convey to your users. Again here, the best thing the UI designer is trying to do is place these in such a way that they're easy to understand and follow to an end user. One key thing here to keep in mind is the use of white and negative space. Simply clumping everything together in the center of the screen is not a very easy way for someone to look at something or interpret it. This is what they're doing with these informational context pieces, trying to lay them out so they're easy to see and easy for users to interact with. Input controls. These are generally going to be form fields such as text boxes, text areas, checkboxes, radio buttons, etc. Again, it's about styling these in a way that are easy to interact and work with. Here at Flying Donkey, we work with a number of clients in the financial industry, and we put together a number of mortgage application and bank application forms. These forms can range in potentially hundreds of fields, and what we want to do is make sure we lay these forms out in such a way that still look good to the end user. If we simply use grey boxes all on one screen, clumped in the middle, the user experience and the user interface design here is poor, and therefore you'll get a high bounce rate and a low completion rate, which will result in poor customer satisfaction and overall less profit for the business. When doing a UI design for these form elements, it's really key to lay them out in such a way that the user is taken on a journey, the form is split up into multiple elements, and they're laid out in such a nice way that they want to continue the process and supply the information they need to do. This is all down to a UI designer's job to make sure that all the elements are captured in a nice way for the user to interact with. What are the most common tools for UI designers? I touched on these earlier, and here at Flying Donkey, we generally use Figma. It's an industry standard online application and allows us to both do design and prototyping in a single application. And it's really cutting edge to allow developers to see what the colors are and the behind the scenes makeup and margins are of a page. And we really recommend users use Figma. Though there are other applications on the market that we also have used in the past that we do also use sometimes on the side. Sketch is one of them. It's really great paired with InVision for prototyping, as well as Photoshop and other photo manipulation software. Generally speaking, the UI designer themselves is going to have a suite of tools that they use to achieve an outcome. These are the ones that we generally find most designers work with, and when we're integrating with a client who has UI designers on their side, we try and match up with the tools that they use. Therefore, we can pass the work back and forth and allow clients to pick up some of the designs and move them forward even after we've gone. What are UI design patterns? UI design patterns is essentially a library of designs that allow a UI designer to sort of shortcut starting from scratch each time they do a design. There are plenty of examples of UI designer frameworks out there, and here at Flying Donkey, one of the ones we use a lot is the Angular material design. It really shows you how a button should look, how it should lay out, how form elements lay out, how text should lay out, etc. It's around shadow and margins and other elements about getting that angular material design. This means that a designer has already got essentially a cheat sheet to work off, and they can really get going and make something that is going to be good for the end users without much effort at all. We highly recommend sticking to one UI design pattern and using one that's already existing. You can add your own colors and flair to the top of a design pattern, but working from a base that is common and best practice is already going to give you an edge in making your products look good for market. UI design is a very key element to application design. If you have a great application that has poor UI design, in my experience, it's not going to go very well. On the flip side, if you have a really good UI design and your functionality isn't quite there, users are generally more forgiving. Here at Flying Donkey, we employ numerous UI and UX designers working in applications such as Figma to do prototyping to work out exactly what an application is going to work and look like and make sure that all the UI design principles are followed. There's really one tip from anything from this video you take away, is that you really invest in your UI design, because how your application looks is how people are going to perceive it. If you need help with any UI design elements or have any questions about UI design, feel free to reach out and have a chat.